So what I'd like to do now is look at a few examples. So the first one is file system testing. We've already talked about this a little bit, so I'm not going to reintroduce this subject. So if we start with a simple file system tester, what we're probably going to do is make a list of all the API calls that we'd like to test. So we can mount and unmount a file system, we can open and close a file, we can create a directory, remove a directory, make a list of all those kinds of functions, and basically just call them randomly with random arguments. Then we'll look at the results and think about them. And what we'll see is that probably our testing is highly suboptimal. Because, for example, if we're throwing unmount calls randomly into the mix, we're going to end up, on average, operating on an unmounted file system at least 50% of the time. Similarly, if there's no correlation in randomly chosen file names between different calls to open, close, and read and write and such, we may effectively never actually perform a read or a write call on an open file. Of course, that's obviously undesirable. So what we're going to do then is, for example, first is special case mount and unmount. We're also going to need to almost certainly special case open and close. And namely, one thing that we might want to do is keep track in the random tester of the set of currently open files. And just these couple of simple things is probably enough to get a file system fuzzer off the ground. But there's more. We'll probably want to limit the size of files so that we don't waste a lot of time writing many, many, many gigabytes to files when we could have been using that time better. And perhaps we also want to limit the height of the directory hierarchy in order that we don't generate incredibly deep directory hierarchies that aren't interesting. On the other hand, we may want to do exactly that. We may want to exactly test extremely deep directory hierarchies or extremely large files, but it might be the case that these are special cases that we want to test separately from the main body of our fuzzer. Okay, so what I hope is that the general pattern is clear here. We start off doing something really simple. We probably observe that it doesn't work very well, and then we start special casing things in order to remove limitations of our random tester. And over time, so maybe over weeks or months or even years, this process ends up with a random tester that will be extremely strong.